Hey CHC, this is Coach Tristan. Welcome to TPTS Chapter 5. Today what we're going to talk about is something crucial to everyday life, especially as we head into the summer months, and that is hydration. Water represents between 45 and 70% of your body weight, clearly making it vital for life. Without it, we can only survive up to 4 to 10 days, compared to food, which we could survive with up to 30 days. Now, if we're looking at water from a performance standpoint, muscle tissue is comprised of 75% of water, whereas fat is comprised of 20%, again, showing how important water is for our muscles and for athletic performance. Now, water is also crucial for cellular function of these muscle tissues, as well as thermal regulation, and that's managing your body temperature, especially with exercise. And this is going to become something that's really important as we head into these summer months and we start sweating a lot, as we start losing a lot of water via sweat, okay? By monitoring this thermal regulation or our internal body temperature with water, we can avoid symptoms of dehydration. Now, these signs of dehydration, which you should be aware of, are muscle soreness, nausea, headache, fatigue, a rapid resting heart rate, a decrease in athletic performance, as well as heat exhaustion or even stroke. With all that said, there are a few things that we need to know, and that's how we should be tracking our fluid intake, when we need to rehydrate, and what kinds of fluids to take in when it comes to rehydrating. Tracking is important, once again, because we do see a significant water loss with sweat and exercise and in extreme heats. In order to track, there's one of two ways that we can be aware of this fluid intake and loss. The first way is that we can actually weigh ourselves. If you weigh yourself before and after exercise, with every 1 pound that you lose, that is equivalent to about 1 pint of fluid loss. And that 1 pint of fluid loss should then be retaken in or rehydrated after you're exercising. Another way is to keep track of your urination. So what research shows us is that average person urinates 4 times a day in between 8 to 10 ounces, okay? The color that we're looking for should be a lemon juice color. Now, if we're looking at something that's a dark yellow, or if our urine, it has a strong odor to it, that's a clear sign of dehydration and you need to start hydrating. You need to start replenishing those fluids and electrolytes back into your body. And that's the next thing we're gonna talk about. Water's great, but what we also need are those electrolytes, okay? Electrolytes, water, and high salty foods will all help us become replenished, rehydrated, and more specifically, those electrolytes are gonna help you with muscle contraction as well as nerve conduction. Two things that are really important to make sure your muscles are working correctly so that you can perform well when you come to the gym. Three specific electrolytes that you should be aware of your intake are potassium, sodium chloride, and calcium, okay? These three electrolytes, like I said, are gonna be really crucial to making sure that you can produce force with your muscles and that your nerves are sending signals efficiently to your muscles. When it comes to rehydration, there's three goals that we're looking for. First thing is that you start exercise already hydrated. Second thing is that you are continuing to hydrate throughout your exercise, especially if you're exercising for a long amount of time. And then the third thing is that when you're done exercising, you still continue to rehydrate, or you replenish those fluids, electrolytes, and higher salty foods back into your diet, especially if you've sweated a lot. Ideally, we're trying to consume water, electrolytes, and high salty foods in regular frequencies throughout the day, as opposed to just trying to chug a whole high volume of water or electrolyte-filled foods into us sporadically throughout the day. We want to regularly be sipping on water or getting those electrolytes back into our body, okay? So that's all that I have for you guys today on hydration. So if you guys have any questions, please come find me or Coach, and we'd be happy to help you out. Have a great day.